Hello, I am Theo Stals of Fieldcast from the OneSource Video Studio, and I am showing you our second adapter that we built. It's the Adapter 2. And the Adapter 2 is meant to be used in conjunction with studio camera of Blackmagic Design. And if you look at the table, you can see what you get if you buy the set of Adapter 2 parts. What I want to show you before we go into the details of the parts is that in principle we are doing what we do with everything. At one side it's our robust cable, at the other side we end up with a LC connection. And in fact, the whole adapter is a kind of bridge from LC to our Fieldcast connection, or the other way around, from Fieldcast to LC. What does Adapter 2 do? Adapter 2 makes the studio camera into a camera with a robust fiber optic connection. What Adapter 1 is for camera converter is Adapter 2 for the studio camera. So we have essentially the same block of aluminum as a basis. Now it's black because the studio camera is black, and people in studios like black cameras and black stuff around black cameras. So we made it black. What you get is the block which has on one side our Fieldcast connector, as you can see. If you know how our color coding works, you can see it's two yellow dots, which means this is a single mode connector which has two cores. And if I take the cable which is next to it, you can see that this is the right cable to use with this adapter, because this cable has two yellow rings. So two yellow rings and two yellow dots means we are ready to marry, we can connect. So this is the main part, the block. On one side, as I told you, the Fieldcast connector. On the other side, it's our friend, the LC connector. And how are you going to connect this block to the studio camera? First thing you do is you mount the connecting plate to it. It's a plate that can be connected to the block with two screws, which are part of the package. The moment you have done it, you have a complete block with the plate, and then you can use the plate to connect it to the camera. We have screws to connect it in two sizes. I will put them on the table as two groups, and I hope you can see that the one group of two screws is a little bit shorter than the other group. We had to do that because we had to have different lengths for situations where you use the sun cap, and situations where you don't use it, because you can't screw very deep into the holes that are on the side and on the top of the Blackmagic camera. So that's the reason we have two different lengths. Simple way of connecting it: you put the screw through the ring, through the plate, into the side of the camera, and use the equipment, the hex keys that are accompanying it, and just connect it to the side. We will go into that shortly. The last part we add to it is a short, nice black, again, a black LC cable. And it connects to the other side of the brick. And the other side of this cable, you connect, obviously, you connect into the SFP, which is part of the studio camera. Well, here we are at the right side of studio camera. And I can show you now how to mount the Adapter 2 to the camera. It's an easy thing to do. We have already mounted the plate to the brick by using the small hex key. So just put the screws in put them firmly, and it's one unit now. So if we have this as a unit, the brick with the plate, we just can connect it very easily to the side of the camera, because Blackmagic Design have all these inserts at the back and at the top and at the other, at the side, at the top and at the other side. But we are using the right side. You can mount it here, you can mount it there, you could also mount it this way, but we have designed it as to be mounted in this way to the camera. Now I can show you, if you use the screws that I've shown you, and I'm using the short ones, that you have enough, you need enough, how do you call it, flesh to go into the inserts. So the short ones you can use to connect it to the camera straight, but when you are using the sun hood, then of course you need extra, and that's the reason that we have the longer screws connected also, also added to the package. But here, because we don't use the hood here, we use the small screws. It's a detail, but some people asked us, why did you do four screws in the package where we only used two? Well, this is the reason. Okay, how to mount it to the camera? Easy, use the screw and the ring. Go to the side of the camera and use the hex key to connect it. Only two of the screws. I'm taking one, the second one, and put it in the other hole and connect it to the camera same way. You don't have to use very extra force to get it on the camera. You can spoil things, but it's not necessary. This is a very, very sturdy connection. Okay, now it's connected to the camera physically, but now we have to do the connections to the camera in terms of the fiber optic connection, in this case, because it's a standard adapter too. And I need a LC patch cable for it, and this is contained with in the package. It's part of the complete package. It's a nice black cable, and a subtle thing, it still has the two yellow rings, so you know for sure it's a single mode cable. Now, you can put it into the SFP of the camera, and it says click, and you are done. The other side you can put in the top of the adapter 2, and it says click, and you're done. So in and out, out and in, you don't have to worry about that. It's done the way it should be done. What do you have to add to get a complete connection? Obviously, our fieldcast cable. I have it here, it's two yellow rings, so the color coding is straightforward, two yellow rings, two yellow rings, two yellow rings, and if you look at the plate which is at the bottom of the adapter, you will see the two yellow dots, so it's a double yellow thing all the way, and you know for sure it's two core single mode. So if you now connect the cable to the adapter, you have done with the studio camera exactly the same as what you have done or can do with camera converter. You have a very, very, very sturdy, robust connection. And the things I always do when I am at trade shows, and I hope I can show you in a very short time if I can get this out of the, from the tripod. I take the cable in my hand and accidentally, which is not an accident of course, I let the camera fall and it just hangs on the cable. This is something I think that proves that the adapter 2 is a real addition to a studio, and in more and for any situation in live events where you want to have it the sturdy way. I thank you very much for your attention, and I hope you appreciate what we Fieldcast try to do with our adapters. Thank you very much.